Hey guys, welcome back. In this lecture, we are starting a new chapter, which is water tank design. And first topic is design of rectangular water tank constructed on ground. Take a new project, space frame, provide name as water tank. Location, length unit is meter and force unit is kilonewton. Next and finish. First draw a plan. Edit, XZ plane. Okay, take top view. I am taking a length of 5 meter and width is 4 meter for this particular water tank. Select all the beams, go to translational repeat, y direction, one step and the height is 3 meter, link steps, okay. Now you have to create a mesh surrounding this. For that go to generate surface meshing. Select all the four columns, then go to quadrilateral meshing. In quadrilateral meshing, you have to provide bias and division. According to length, I am providing a division. If the length is 5 meter, I am providing a 5 divisions. If length is 3 meter, I am providing 3 division. If length is 5 meter, I am providing 5 and then 3. Then click on OK. Apply. Look at this. There is a mesh of plates created. All these are a plate. Okay. Again, take a command, generate surface meshing. And select all the four nodes one by one up to first quadrilateral. Okay, 4 divisions, 3, 4, and 3 according to length. Okay, apply. Five, three, apply. At the bottom, you need to create plate. If you want to cover this particular tank at top, just create a plate at top also. Okay, all the geometry is complete. Now you can delete all these beams and columns because we don't need. Do not delete a bottom beam. Okay, it's your tank. Go to general property, define rectangle. I am providing a bottom beam as 0.8 meter depth and 0.4 meter width. Go to thickness, For all the water tank plates, I am taking 0.2 meter. And at the top, the cover is 0.12 meter. Assign to view. It will assign in all the beams. Take plate thickness and select all the plates. Do not select the top plate. Assign to selected plates, assign and yes. Select next property and apply it at the top plate, a cover plate. Assign to selected plates, assign and yes. Then go to support, create, fix support, add. Your water tank is constructed on ground, so you need to provide fixed support to all the bottom nodes. Assign to selected nodes, assign and yes. Okay, all the bottom nodes are supported to ground. Load and definition, load case detail, add, select dead load, provide a name as dead load, select live load, in dead load I am providing self weight of that particular structure, self weight y direction factor minus 1, add and close, select this, assign to view, assign and yes. In live load, I am providing hydrostatic pressure which are coming on that particular tank wall. Live load, add. Go to the plate loads and hydrostatic. Look at this. For this particular load, you need to apply live load. First, you have to check plate orientations. For that, click on that particular screen and press Shift plus T. Shift T and go to top view and look at this. Observe the Z direction. It will change each and every time. For this phase, Z is outer side. For this phase also Z is outer side. Okay. For this phase Z is inner side. For this phase also Z is inside. So remember, we are applying a load at local Z direction. In this phase we have to apply positive load. In this phase also we have to apply positive load, because local Z is outside of that particular phase and we are applying a load along the local Z direction. In this phase pressure is negative. This phase also we have to apply pressure as negative because Z is inside. And we have to apply pressure inside to outside. Okay. If the water is present inside the water tank, it will apply pressure from inside to outside of this tank. So, this phase positive pressure. In this phase also, we have to apply positive pressure. In this phase negative pressure, in this phase also negative pressure. For each new water tank you have to check plate orientation because it will change, and system to system also it will change. Okay, close the plate orientation from Shift T, go to live load, add plate loads, hydrostatic, then go to select plate,
once again, live load, add, plate loads and hydrostatic. Go to select plates. In select plate, first take plate cursor and select the positive faces. In these two faces, we have to apply positive load. So first select the positive Z1. Done. In W1, provide a hydrostatic pressure which is equal to rho gh of water. Rho is the density of water. G is 9.81 and h is the height of tank. Our height of tank is 3 meters. So it will come around 30 kilonewton per meter square. I am taking W1 is equal to 30 kilonewton per meter square. W2 is 0. Interpolate along global axis. It is y direction. And then direction of pressure will be local z. Go to add and close. Look at this. We applied a hydrostatic pressure. The intensity at the bottom of that particular tank is 30 kilonewton per meter square. At the top of that particular tank, it is 0, W1 and W2. And interpolation along y direction, because increment or decrement of that load is along y direction. And the load is applied along the z direction. Okay, from shift T we find out the local directions. Then again go to live load, add, plate loads, hydrostatic, select plates. Take a plate cursor and select where Z is inside. All the faces where Z is inside. Done. In W1, minus 30. If Z is inside, then you have to provide a negative pressure, minus 30. W1 and W2 is 0. Interpolate along y direction. Direction of pressure Z. Add and close. Now we apply hydrostatic pressure to all the faces. Now the load of water also come in bottom plate. So we have to apply load in bottom plate also. Live load, add, go to plate loads and pressure on full plate. Okay. For the bottom plate, go to plate loads and select pressure on full plate. Provide load as minus 30 and the direction is GY. Because at bottom plate, load is applied on y direction, global y direction. So we apply it in GY. Add and close. Select that load. Take a front view. Take plate cursor and select bottom plate. Assign to selected plates. Assign and yes. Look at this. At the bottom pressure or at the bottom plate, we applied all pressure. Now create a load combinations. Auto load combination, Indian code, generate, add and close. All the combinations are created. Then go to analyze print, add, close, analyze and run analysis. Save. Go to post processing mode and done. Okay. You can see displacement, reactions. In beam, you will find out shear force, bending moment and deflection. Axial forces. In graph, you will find out all the bending moment graphs. Go to the plate. Select the stress type, maximum absolute. Click on OK. Look at this. With the help of these function, you will find out all the pressure coming on that particular structure. Just change the load, dead load, live load, generate 1, combination 2, combination 3, and combination 4. From this, you will find out all the pressure coming on that particular structure. You can take picture also and generate a report of that, all that things, as we learned in report generation chapter. Okay, go to modeling, design, concrete design, IS456, design parameters, FC. I'm providing 30,000. FY main 500. Maximum main 20, maximum secondary 10, minimum main, minimum secondary. Select and assign to view. Go to commands, design beam, add design column, add design slab element, add take off, add and close. Design beam assigned to all beams. Okay, there is no column, delete it. Design element assigned to view. And assign it. Go to analyze print, analyze that, and then analyze, run analysis. Output file. It's a concrete design for beam. For all the plates, and take off. Thanks for watching this.